Everyone, I am Dr Sikandar, consultant PETCT in radiology from Yashodha Hospital, Somajgura, Hyderabad. I will be speaking on PETCT newer applications. As you know, PETCT has evolved a very long way from the basic investigation, imaging investigation, to the sophisticated investigation in various applications. So in this lecture, I will be showing you a couple of cases where PETCT has evolved and the newer applications can be done for diagnosis of various pathologies.
Now I will be showing a lot of newer applications of PETCT. This is a 15 years old with epilepsy. The PET was advised and the PET shows diffuse hypometabolism in bilateral parietal lobes, especially in cortical and subcortical deep white matter. So, history of epilepsy with diffuse hypometabolism in parietal lobes, that gives the indication of epileptogenic focus. This is second case with 48 years old with fever on and off from last 6 months. The X-ray was done, which shows nothing specific except cardiomegaly and some sort of subsegmental atelectasis. Otherwise, lateral doesn't have any much relevance. Because of pyrexia of unknown origin, fever, the PET-CT was done, and the PET-CT shows diffuse circumferential uptake along the thoracic aorta. This thoracic aorta involves arch of aorta and descending thoracic aorta. And there is minimal wall thickening which is seen involving the aortic wall. So that is consistent with the aortic wall inflammation. That is a case of aortoaortitis. So you have a lot of cases where you can diagnose medium size, small size as well as large size vasculitis in these settings. This is another case, pyrexia of unknown origin for last 3 months. The PET was advised, which shows subtle hypodensity with less enhancement compared to the adjoining renal parenchyma in the right kidney. So it was a focus of infection, that is pyelonephritis. But if you see again in the lower pole of the left kidney, it shows the focal area of uptake. So it is a case of bilateral pyelonephritis. This was a known case of Cox, which shows a caseating left cervical nodal mass here, but there was a knee pain and back pain by which the PET was done, which shows D12 vertebral body, which shows patchy sclerosis and associated subtle, there was a subtle soft tissue component, and the knee joint, which shows again there is a minimal uptake secondary to synovial thickening. So it was a case of cervical nodal tuberculosis with D12 vertebral as well as knee joint involvement. This is one of the exciting applications of the PET which is being evolved in today's era, because any sort of metallic prosthesis imaging is very difficult. CT, lot of artifacts, MRI is not compatible. So only remaining alternative is a PET-CT. So PET, when you are doing this PET, there is subtle area of focal collection here, which is very difficult to be seen, and this shows consistent with the minimal uptake in this area. So this is a minimal collection, this is a collection. So that is how you can see any sort of infective focus which is involving the prosthesis. This is another case of liver and splenic abscesses, known case where which came as a pyrexia of unknown origin, but here any other thing which was diagnosed was a pancreatic pseudocyst in a known case of pancreatitis. So you have a splenic abscess, you have a liver abscess, and again pancreas, pancreatitis with pseudocyst formation. So these are all the three different etiologies but leading to pyrexia of unknown origin. Pyrexia of unknown origin is also one of the important entity as far as investigations. We do roughly around 20-25% of the cases every day related with PUO protocol. So here after doing PUO, there was a splenomegaly which shows diffuse uptake involving the entire splenic parenchyma and histopathology which was confirmed to be NHL. Now this already I have shown large and small vasculitis. If you see the diffuse uptake which I have shown in the previous case, but if you see the iliac vessels and the proximal arteries of the both thighs and the proximal aspects of the subclavian vessels. So here medium as well as small cell vasculitis is also one of the important indication for the evaluation by the PET-CT. This is very interesting case. Post liver transplantation 3 months. There are liver shows subtle irregular hypodensities with fever on and off. This was consistent with multiple focal areas of abscesses secondary to the infection after the liver transplant. So equally liver transplant success has to be followed up with different types of investigations, and PET in this sort of settings is equally helpful in diagnosing the focus. Coming to Paget's in the pelvic bone, Paget's is not an indication for the PET, but it was an incidental finding to differentiate between the sclerosis or sclerotic metastasis. But here the diffuse hemivertebra enlarged in size with focal area of uptake persistent in the delayed scan. So this goes more in a favor of Paget's. But ultimately Paget's is not a thing which you should diagnose by the PET, but you can see the amount of the uptake and differentiate it with sclerotic metastasis. Now there is a focal area of in the popliteal fossa here, which shows there is some sort of inflammation which is happening on the sides. Diffuse myositis bilateral, both different cases, but there is increased uptake on the contralateral side which is not equal. There is another case of peritonitis on the left side which shows uptake compared to the right side. So this is consistent with peritonitis. This is another case of left psoas abscess tuberculosis. If you see the psoas muscles, they are asymmetrical. Left is bulky, which shows focal area of uptake that is consistent with the left psoas abscess tuberculosis. This is very unusual case, subungual poroma, where you have focal area of uptake involving the thenar muscles of the left hand, which shows focal area of uptake. It is non-malignant condition, but incidentally it came and histopathology proved out to be subungual poroma. Now myositis is one of the thing where you should focal area CT is absolutely non-specific, but PET shows diffuse area of uptake. This was a case of polymyositis where again the diffuse uptake involving the muscles. These are two different cases actually, which shows diffuse uptake in the muscles. And the another one of the important diffuse uptake in the muscle is when you have very high sugar. Sugar should be usually less than 150. Otherwise, you are supposed to give insulin and try to make the sugar normal and do the PET scan. But if you are not doing it and with a very high sugar of 150 and above, probably you will land up in having this sort of images. So these are the things which you should remember. So these are a couple of cases which I have shown to you as far as the non-oncological newer applications of the PET. With this, I finish this short talk and I expect that you have learned basics about the newer applications. Thank you for your kind attention.